So I'm here with my friend Humphrey, and he is an American that has a lot of experience here in Thailand. He's been coming out to Thailand for, you know, on and off for maybe over 2 decades.
Yes.
And he has a few tips here that I think is good for us to listen to, because I saw my analytics, the majority of people watching, including myself, are guys. And he's a man that is close to 50 years old now, and he has a lot of good experience to maybe share with us. So what are 5 tips that you have for us, Humphrey?
Yeah, so I have, yep, you're right. I've been coming here for more than 20 years. And probably if you total up all my stays, I've got about 6 to 7 years total here. And now I've been here living for the past year full time. And I quit my job at Cisco. I was working as a SE, as a sales engineer for Cisco for 7 years. So my tips for you guys, first one is have enough money and savings or income when you come here. Don't be cutting it so close to where you're just on the knife edge. And let's say you have $800 a month to spend, or $1,000 a month to spend. And you're gonna keep it right at $1,000 a month, and you're not accounting for any emergencies. The baht can go up and down. It can move. Your expenses can go up and down. You could have you could break your leg. I've seen that. There was a forum post on Reddit where someone broke their hip. So they came here, and like in the first week they broke their hip, and now they're running short on money. So that's my number one tip: is make sure you're accounting for a decent budget. We're not saying totally cheap out. We're not saying, you know, you need to bring $1 million, but, you know, have enough money, like $2,000 a month, $3,000 a month, and you can kind of go up from there, and have a decent amount of savings if you are planning to retire here. Don't just totally cheap out, and you need to account for the emergencies. And, you know, that probably brings me into number two is, you know, having a routine, having, you know, keeping busy, being productive, and not going to the bars every day, because that will get you into trouble really, really quick. You're going to, and I've seen it, and I've done a little bit of it as well. You know, you're gonna have 1 or 2 beers, right? And then your friends are gonna visit, because everyone likes to visit you when you're in Bangkok and in Pattaya. And of course, when you're out with your friends, you're going to do 3 beers or 4 beers. And, you know, maybe one night you start doing wine as well. So you're just going to start drinking a lot. And then you're going to start waking up later. You've got that hangover. So you're going to wake up at 10 a.m., 11 a.m. Now it's noontime. Well, if you're waking up at noontime, maybe the next day you might as well wake up at 3 p.m., right? And, you know, what's going to happen? One day you're going to say, screw it, 6 p.m. The whole day is gone. And you've done absolutely nothing. So that's my tip is, you know, really watch it with the drinking and the partying. Not saying to cut it completely out, but what I would do is maybe keep it to the weekends. Do your normal productive routine Monday through Friday, and then keep your partying on the weekends. Or you do Monday, Wednesday, Friday, something like that. Don't be constantly drinking all the time and going to bars and stuff. Third tip is watch it with the girls. You know, use protection, be careful with your money, have your wits about you, because I know with my viewership for the Router Gods YouTube channel, my viewership is 96.7% male. And yeah, of course, being Router Gods, it's a lot of IT people. And you know, IT people, especially if you've never visited Thailand before, and you've never visited an Asian country before. This is your first time into Asia. And so boom, you go absolutely nuts. You go level 10 right away, and you go to Bangkok or Pattaya. And it's something you're not used to. Like, you've never seen this before. This is completely alien. And beer prices are cheap, so you start drinking a lot. And maybe you don't smoke, but now you smoke because you've gone to 7-Eleven and you've bought a pack of cigarettes. Everyone else is smoking, so now you're smoking. And you're going to the bars and you're meeting up with girls and you open up Tinder. We were talking about this with Tinder, is that hey, in the US, you're a nerdy IT guy. You don't get any Tinder hits, or maybe you get the wrong Tinder hits. But in Thailand, you fire up Tinder, and because you put in you're an American and you're white and you're this tall, that maybe you're getting dozens or hundreds of hits, right? So that can alter your perception of reality really, really quick. And so just be careful with that. Have your wits about you. Be careful with your money. Be careful with who you, what you say. Don't say I have like 500K in the bank or $1 million in the bank or whatever.
That would be moving towards like tip number four.
Tip number four is
the money.
The money situation.
Be careful.
Careful with your money.
Mm-hmm.
Be very careful with your money. My big tip for you guys is have an exit point. So if you save up your money and you come to Thailand, have a point in your bank account where you bug out, or you start thinking about like, okay, I really should think about going back to the U.S. I really should think about leaving Thailand right now. Maybe working, going back to Singapore and working. Is that
or a getting an online job or something?
Yeah, it's like there should be a point where you hit in your bank account where you start going, oh crap, I need to either start making money again or go back in the workforce or go back to the U.S. Because what I see a lot of people do is they don't think about this beforehand. They come here and the bank account is dropping and dropping and dropping, and then it's too late. Like you may not have enough money to fly back. You may have to beg your relatives or
put it on a credit card or something.
Or heaven forbid you dig into your 401k, right? So just have some preset point. In my case, it's 100K. So if my bank account starts hitting 100K US, I should start looking, right? I'm not too worried because you can make 100K last a decent amount, but have a breakout point where you maybe start thinking about going back to the US. And tip number five, staying with the girls theme, wearing protection is,
What about being careful about like the different tactics that some certain girls might use? Like, possibly like, for example, the famous YouTuber who, bought a house for his girlfriend, put everything in his girlfriend's name, and then they ended up breaking up. Yeah. And he actually lost about $150,000 worth of houses and cars and motorcycles. And for some people, that could be quite drastic.
Yes. So be very careful in terms of buying houses, real estate for other people, especially if you're in a girlfriend / wife situation, because the laws are, I won't say it's like completely rigged against you, but they are heavily skewed for the Thais. So what I mean by that is if you enter in a contract to buy a house, let's say you want to buy a house, well, you as a foreigner, you can't buy a house. You can't buy the land. Right? You could buy condos, but you can't buy a landed house. A Thai person can. Right?
Well, that's what you wanted to say too, right? Is that if someone comes out here, they should rent instead of buying.
Yes.
At least for the first part.
Yeah. So the rental part is, okay, if you've never been to Thailand before, don't just plunk down 300K for a condo right away. Because one, you don't know the condo situation around here. You don't know what the good condos are, what the bad condos are. You don't know the neighborhood. You could make the mistake of buying a condo in a neighborhood that totally sucks. Or I'll give you a good example, Ashton Asok.
I've been there.
Yes.
Yeah.
Ashton Asok, it's next to Asok Terminal 21. It's a great condo. I love it. I was stayed there during quarantine, during COVID. It has a chance of being torn down because the way they built it is it's on MR. There's a driveway and the driveway is on MRT land. And there's a legal case about how much space, and it's complicated. But the long and the short of it is their permit to exist, the construction permit, has been revoked.
Oh.
So you bought a condo, you sunk down, let's say, 300K US for a condo at Ashton Asok. You didn't do your research. And then, boom, this court case comes down, and it could, they could bulldoze the place.
Wow.
Which totally sucks, and you're, you know, nothing you could really do. Now, what I personally think is things will be, people will be paid, and it won't come to that point. But that's the danger, is that don't buy. You don't need to buy right away. Check out the different neighborhoods. If you like to party, get a place near a party zone and party for the first year. Mm-hmm. Do a one-year lease. Or do an Airbnb for 2 or 3 months and then work out something with the owner. Rent prices are pretty cheap. I mean, you know, we were talking about it, is if you don't need to be right in the center of town, if you're okay with being Urumsuk, Hoi Kwong, Ekamai, then you can get places for 15,000 baht and below. So we're talking $500 US and lower, and sometimes less than 10,000 baht, like $300 or lower. So it can be very, very affordable. So you don't need to buy, because don't expect prices to increase. That's another thing with condos in Thailand and much of Asia. Asians don't like to buy used condos, generally. You know, in the US, we buy houses, like we'll buy a pre-owned house. It's completely fine, right? The house prices go up. It's owned by another person. Like, it's no big deal. It happens every day. Asians buy new, generally. They want to buy a new shiny condo. They don't generally want to buy a used condo. So that's another thing that works against you. So,
yeah. But that could also move into your favor if you actually like the used condos, because you could get a much cheaper price.
Yes.
For those condos, sometimes.
You could turn that thinking around, because now you're the crazy guy wanting to buy the used condo that the Thais won't want to buy. But yeah, also really look into the laws for buying. So that's another thing, is there's a lot of interesting laws in Thailand regarding buying of condos and, you know, the quota for foreigners. Mm-hmm. If you're American like I am, you might really like a condo, a room in this particular condo, but you might not be able to buy it because already a bunch of Americans and Russians and Chinese have already bought their condos, and it's already at 49%, right? So 49% can be owned by other than Thais, and 51% at least have to be owned by Thais. Mm-hmm. So you could run into the situation where, let's say you bought a condo, you try to sell it. You can't sell it because the quota, you know, it will mess up the quota, and there's just no one will buy it.
Or you can only sell it to a Thai person.
You could only sell it to a Thai person.
Kind of limits your pool a little bit.
Who doesn't want to buy a used condo, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So, those are all really good tips. And, thank you so much, Humphrey.
Yeah, not a problem.
For sharing those tips. And you can also let us know your thoughts, too, in the comments below. And we'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Bye-bye.
Talk to you later.